Golly, that sucks. And of course, we die at the end just a cherry on the egg and top. Yeah, man. All right. Let's spawn back at the bog, and I guess we'll just head back over to the heck and, I don't know, maybe I'll do the mission all the way up to that last scavenger hunt area. That way we don't have to see us doing the same heckin' footage over again. But I guess that we'll just use our jetpack for that last area, because that takes heckin' forever.
Ready for action!
And now our Ferox is stranded over there, so we've got a rescue mission ahead of us, you guys. We need to go back over there, and I don't have very good armor. So, man. I don't know if we have anything good. We have some fur. A fur over here. Okay, we have leggings, we have gauntlets, we have a hat. We don't have a chest piece, unfortunately. Do we have a flak? We don't have flak there. I think I might have grinded it up. Flak. We have flak leggings. Hypothermal 18. Hypothermal 118. Might be better to get her up. Chest piece. I guess we'll get a chitin. That'll be fine, I guess. Oh no, we have a riot right there. Nice. So let's get the riot, and that should be a full set right there. Oh wait, we need boots. Oh wait, we have the hat, don't we? Did we get the hat? Yeah, there it is right there. I don't know why you didn't get the hat. Boot. Do I have any boots? I have hazard suit and desert cloth, and riot. No, hazard suit again. Man, I guess I'll wear it. It's better than nothing, huh? So there you go. Now we need to go heck and rescue our heckin' stuff, you guys. So let's go away from our heckin' base. That way we can go teleport over there with Helena. And we don't have anything. We don't even have a jetpack or anything like that, you guys. Yeah, oh my god, this is going to be a crazy rescue mission. I actually don't know what to do here, you guys. Should I make another... Can I make another jetpack over here? I don't know if I can. At least the jetpack glider bit. I don't know if I can, you guys. Oh, yep, there it is right there. 120 metal ink. Can I make that? Man, I'm missing a lot of metal. So 120 metal ingots no matter what. 60 metal ingots if I just want the glide in the backpack. So, man... I might end up buying some metal here, you guys, from Helena, because this is an emergency situation, so let's try and get back. What in the world? Can I not talk to her? What? Oh my god. Oh, there you go. Jeez, I don't know why I can't talk to her sometimes. Yeah, we've got 42,000 heckin' hexagons. We might as well use them, right? Sheesh. Oh man, but it's going to be so expensive. I get 120 of these things, like, golly. Oh, well, you get 5 at a time, so let's go down to, there you go, 4,000 hexagons to get that much metal. Or I guess I could do this, get a little bit less metal. Actually, yeah, I'd have to get a lot because you have to get double. So I have to get like 240 or something like that, right? So like that. Yeah, it'd be a little bit cheaper. But of course, I'd have to smelt it and that'd take a little bit of time. But I think it's worth it. Let's do it. I cannot move after I buy these. So let's do it. Let's buy all these heckin' metals for 3,600 heckin' hexagons. It'll pay for itself, I'm sure, after we do this hexin... combining hexagon and heckin'. But after we do this this mission again here, I'm sure we'll be able to... Let's see, does this say how much, where is it? Arctic biome? No, we're only going to get 750. I put my life on the line for 750 hexagons. That's nothing. Man, alright, well, whatever. We'll go back there eventually here in just a moment. But for right now, I do want to go... Oh, well, we do have 4 forges, right? So we just split this up and get 60 in each one of these things. Get some spark powder in them. And hopefully they'll smelt out pretty quickly. And of course we have some gasoline over here we could use for fuel. So don't really need to worry about that too much. 64.7. Has a little bit, 92. Has a little bit better hypothermal insulation. And it's like just 0.1 better armor range. So I guess I'll use those pants instead. So there you go. Nice. All right, let's grab some spar powder now and put them up inside there if I have any. I don't know if I do. I guess I can try and make some. There you go. We have a bunch of spar powder right there. Let's go evenly distribute it between all these. Put about 27 in each one. That's going to be way too much, but at least we'll have a little bit left over. And let's light them all up and I guess just like slow-mo 1 trillion. There we go. Hopefully that's good. Oh man, I moved so I can fast. Yeah, I'm still taking a little while to get all these real quick, but at least we're saving about 1,000 hexagons rather than just buying 1,000 metal ingots outright, right? But either way, yeah, let me just let these smelt real quick and we'll make the jetpack and all that kind of stuff so I can actually, you know, move around decently. And then I guess maybe I'll look and see if we have like a... Oh, I'm moving so fast. Do we have any weapons over here? Like, of course we have some guns that I could use, but I don't know if I want to use those here, you guys. But, you know, like, I guess I could just use like a regular sword or something like that. You know, something I can actually defend myself with if I do get attacked. Oh, I think it's all done. I think it's all done. Yep, 30 ingots inside of there. Oh, whoops, that's the wrong button. This one's slow-mo one. Oh, there we go. All right. Now we should be able to, I might as well turn them all off. There you go. Out fire, out fire, out fire. Nice. And, oh yeah, we don't have to go over there. It's in my inventory, isn't it? So it's a glide suit. It's the one with the backpack and the jetpack. So that'd be that one, jetpack, glider, and backpack. So there we go. We got it. I guess I'll put that on my riot suit armor thing. There we go. Chest piece. Once it's done, there we go. Let's get ourselves some gasoline. 20, that should be fine. That's more than enough. And then, of course, load it inside of our thing. There we go. And, I'd have to get a little bit more metal. I guess if anything, I could have, like, salvaged something over here and get a little bit of metal out of it, huh? But, yeah, a little bit too late for that now, huh? Well, we got some flag leggings there. I guess I could grind these up or salvage them. See if we can get anything out of it. Oh, we have a little bit of raw metal right there. A little bit of metal ingots right there, too. And we're up to 11. That's nothing. I think we actually need, like, 40 or something like that to get a sword. Let's see. Yeah, we need, like, 50, golly. I can make a sword plus. God, man. Yeah, but I'm going to avoid doing that. Just because, you know, we're going up against vanilla creatures, so. Yeah, I need 50, I can metal ingots. I guess, I don't know if we have any guns over here that actually has ammo. I don't know if I have any ammo. I don't think I do. I guess if anything, we just kind of go in and out, maybe. Try and just kind of grab our heckin' stuff back. And then maybe, if we do end up getting our stuff back, at least we'll have all of our stuff and get our sword, we get everything else, and then maybe redo the mission. There you go, 300 hexagons back. Nice, that's like half of the heckin' hexagons we're gonna get from doing this mission anyways. Biome teleportation. Oh yeah, where do we die on that? That's the Arctic base, which isn't too far away from this, so I guess we'll go to north? I guess either north or north. I'll go to northeast. So that'd be northeast. There you go.
Time to teleport!
Hopefully that's actually going to take us pretty close to the thing. But, you know, once we get... Oh, I actually get set it on this. Unless I already have it set. Do I already have it set? I don't think I do. Let's set it as our current mission. So it's going to be searching for the Frozone. And, oh, I guess I can't do it because I'm not in the biome right now. Okay, well, we'll do that here in just a moment.
Coordinates confirmed. Teleport complete.
All right, nice. Wait, what? How is that northeast? I'm, like, in the southwest. What? I have no idea why I'd want to be here, golly. Now, where am I going to go? I guess, whoops. That's the wrong button. Didn't mean to glide just yet. We do have a decent amount of, I think I know where I'm at. Yeah, that's the main mountain, so I just need to go, like, to the other side of this mountain, I think, right? What in the world? The flames are, like, in front of me. What? That's kind of crazy. Oh, God. A little bit of fall damage right there, unintentionally. Anyways, good news, real quick. Just want to update you guys. Found Baby Yoda. There he is. And, oh, something's attacking. What? Deodons? Or wolves? I can't tell. I can tell from here, though. I need to be really careful. I need to go over there, grab my stuff back. We have decent armor right now. It could be better. We're going to grab all that. There we go. Grabbed it all back. And I think my dead body, yep, it just got harvested by that Deodon. Man. Oh, whoa, that was pro. I just, like, swooped under that hacking tree right there. I'm gonna grab all my stuff back, because it has two inventories of- Oh god, I'm taking hardcore damage! I can dead on- man! I need to, like, lure that thing away! Oh my god, it's hanging out right next to my heckin' bed dead body again. My flamethrower, or my jetpack thing was, like, by my feet right there. That's kinda crazy. Can't see with my jetpack in the way. It's still over there? I think we're good. Still doing really poorly on health right now, you guys. That's terrible. Grab- Oh god, it's right there again! You kidding me?! Oh no. Oh my god, you kidding me? What am I supposed to do? I don't know. I need to, like, lure it away. Come on, where is it? There it is right there. And then I'm gonna fly in the air. I need to get some food or something like that to heal up. And of course I have some food in that heckin' inventory right there. I need to grab it back. I don't know where the heckin' dead on is, but I'm gonna grab it. Oh, grabbed all of it back, nice. Alright, now we can get to a safer position. Can't eat while I'm flying, unfortunately, so that sucks. Let's actually turn the gamma up, because it is extremely dark for me right now. There we go. Alright, that's good. Okay, really good cliff right here. Great! Really good mission right there to get my stuff back. That's great. Let's put our flak on now. There we go. We've got a sword down there. Maybe I'll worry about the folders a little bit later. Thankfully, we saved Baby Yoda right there, too, so that's great. Seems like we're back to normal now, you guys. So that's awesome. So, yeah, let me just eat some food. Try and heal back up, and then once we start the searching the Frozone mission again, I guess I'll give Baby Yoda another thing of, I don't know how addicted he is. I guess I'll check here in just a moment. I don't know where a good spot to check would be that's, you know, relatively safe. Oh, there you go, gliding. No fall damage right there, nice. Let me check his addiction. 13%. Yeah, apparently the better, the higher the addiction, the more, of course, more emerald, or more, element you have to give him, and of course more powerful he's going to be too, so that's good. I don't know if that means he's also going to last shorter amount of time or something like that. I didn't look into that, but Maybe I'll give him some more melee damage. There you go. I don't know how much melee damage he had last time. It's been a while. Last time he was like in big scary mode, you know. We do have some health over here, so yeah, let's take a blood pack. Just, you know, heal up a little bit if I can. Yeah, just a little tiny little bit. There you go. Unfortunately, that's not going to really help us out too much, but that in combination with just eating should help us out to heal up to full health at the 4:30 and, you know, be fine. But yeah, for right now, let me just pause the recording, head back over to searching the Froze Zone, do the first like three or so locations, then I'll see you guys here in a bit once we come back to this location, try and find like three or four little artifacts or whatever we have to find for the scavenger hunt. So I'm going to pause the recording and I'll see you guys here in just a bit. Alright guys, I'm back. Just found the first thing over here on the last area. Let's try and grab it. There you go, gather. 2 minutes remaining. So that's good. Getting a good start right there, I'd say. Although, we still have 2 whole minutes to get 3 more, like, things that we have to gather. And this is, like, a blinding fog around here. Why do I keep... Man, no wonder I keep dying out here. Or died that one time, that is. Jeez. Oh man, poop right there. Which way are we going? This way for another one, right? Oh wait, yep, there it is right there. There's a second one. Yeah, I think these are spawning in different locations. Because the ones that were, like, underwater and all that. Yeah, look at this, there's, like, no visibility. But all those other ones that I did just a moment ago off camera, they're like in different locations. So let's see, I guess, yeah, we keep going straight here. So yeah, I guess these ones are going to be in different locations as well. So can't just go to the same spot over and over, just grind it over and over again, I guess, huh? I guess just keep going in a straight line. We have a minute to get 2 more. Where in the world is it? Man, like it took 2 minutes to come over here. And now they're, oh my gosh. Is it actually all the way up there? Or did I pass it? I guess I passed it. Okay, let's not die from fall damage. There it is. Okay, let's grab it. Good thing I have this thing. I'm gonna take a little bit of fall damage right there. Now let's see, how far away is this last one? We have 50 seconds. Don't tell me it's gonna be another repeat of last time. Okay, this way. Let's go, let's go. There's an avalanche, but that's not gonna stop me. We're flying around. I don't see the thing. I know! Where is it? Oh my gosh. There it is! There it is! Fine a heckin'ly!
Good on ya!
Oh my gosh, yes! Jeez! I don't know how much time we had left there at the end, but golly, that took... That was way too... I don't know if I could do the alpha version of that. I don't know how much time they're gonna give that one, but... going from the the river that's melting and flowing and all that kind of stuff from the exact opposite side of this heckin' giant mountain all the way over here took like 2 minutes or something like that. So I have no idea how you're supposed to come over here and do all that. Whoa, almost just died. Anyways, yeah, we got a lot of heckin' stuff right there. My inventory is still full of trash, so I need to make those folders and stuff. But looks like we got a pretty good amount of stuff here, you guys. Now, I think ending here is all the stuff that we were wearing, so all this stuff is new. So, Precoptodon Saddle Journeyman, and some Focal Jelly, Ramshackle Pump Action Shotty. Yeah, I definitely need, we did get a shotgun earlier, didn't we? I need to figure out where it is and get, of course, more ammo for it. Another Battle Tartar, Mind Wipe Tonic, Primitive Riot Helmet, not too bad. Maybe we'll move on over to that here in the future. But for right now, we need flak because of the hypothermal insulation meme here in the wintry area. And a Plesiosaur Saddle Apprentice, Ghillie Leggings, Precoptodon Saddle again, a Blueprint for an Ascendant, Mega Kalunk. Golly, look at that, 5,000 metal ingots for that. And a Heavy Miner's Helmet, Medical Brew, that's going to be good. I'm going to take that. There you go, because I need to heal up, like, right now. There you go, and then eat some more food if I can, just to heal up even more. There you go, nice. And, Ramshackle Arthropleura Saddle, another Precoptodon, Fur Gauntlets, Ramshackle Assault Rifle, Kalian Soup, Biomia Saddle, Scuba Mask right there. I don't know if we have that. I think we do, yeah. I don't think it's anything new. And I think that should cover all the loot that we got right there. And, of course, like, only 700 or something like that hexagons, so that sucks. Yeah, 750, so that sucks. 44 million, I don't know what that means. Surely not 44, like, seconds left, because I think around the 30-second mark, Helena was, like, yelling at me, saying, oh, you need to hurry up, Hayda. There you go, eat another blood pack right there. Eat some more food, and hopefully keep regenning, but for right now, yeah, what am I going to get rid of? We're not really over-encumbered. We're just not able to jump, and of course we can't use... Oh, wait, yeah, we can use the jet. Ooh, okay. Well, oh, yeah, I guess we can just teleport, huh? And can we still, I can't glide. Uh-oh. Better not die. I need to strategically land with my jetpack. Hold on, do I still have gamma up? I think I might have gamma still up. I need to turn it down. Oh, nice little landing right there, nice. Oh, I did have Gamma up right there. Whoops. Say hello. Hey, almost just got another half of the hexagons I just earned right there, so that's good. We're at 40,000, so that's great. Biome teleportation. Arctic... No, whoops. Man, the heckin' screen keeps shaking here. Arctic North. There you go. Yeah, I don't know what the direct... Why the directions are, like, so hecked up over here, but... Yeah, once we go back to the Arctic base, which is, like, right next to this teleport, we need to make a bed immediately, you guys. That way we can teleport back to the Arctic base whenever we heckin' die over here, because I guess that's the first time we've actually died here in the Arctic. And then, mission-wise, I don't know if I want to do a mission just yet, so I guess I'll untrack that once. We'll have that, like, on the screen anymore. Then, of course, we'll put up all this stuff in storage. We'll salvage some of the items I probably won't use, and, I guess just store it all up inside the vaults and all that kind of stuff. That's going to be good.
It's confirmed. Teleport complete.
All right, nice. So where are we going? Oh, yeah, there's another glitch up there. So let's see. Yep, this way, I think, is our base. Yeah, that's the other one that I thought was our base, but this one over here is the actual base. Yeah, unfortunately, we can't use the glide right now, so I guess I'll just go over this hill and just jetpack over there, which I think we're still moving a little bit faster than if we're walking on the ground. And, of course, right now, if we were walking on the ground, we'd be even slower, but... You know, more normal movement speed. I think we're still moving faster using the jetpack here, so that's good. And out here we have the upgrade station, so I guess we'll salvage some of the items I probably won't use, like, you know, the saddles and stuff. Which one am I probably gonna ask? Plesiosaur saddle and Precompton saddle. Yeah, I'm probably not gonna tame one. Precompton, blueprint right there. Yeah, I need to make a bookshelf so I can actually store up these blueprints and keep track of them here in the future. Although that one that requires like 5,000 metal, probably not gonna make that because I think I already have a pretty good Megacalon saddle. Which is the giant turtle creature over in the ocean biome. I think we already have one of those back in the bog. And a Fiomia saddle, yeah. Precompton, Orthoplura, eh. Probably won't tame that one. Plesiosaur, I don't know, maybe I'll get that. I think we already have, like, multiple Plesiosaur saddles now that I think about it. Salvage all those, and we got a 1480 hide, 200 pelt, 673 fiber, and this was empty, by the way, so all this stuff we got from the saddles. 172 metal, and even more pelt right there. I guess it only stacks up to 200, which is crazy, because everything else stacks up to like a heck of 1,000 or something. 13 wood randomly, 4 flint, 55 cemented base, which is good, because, you know, we usually don't have cemented base. A little bit of obsidian right there, 17. And speaking of such, there's some not too far away from here. And even some silica pearls right there, so hey, that's not too bad, I suppose. Is there anything else here, like random armor I can get rid of? Yeah, we have our old riot armor. I definitely want to go put that up. Some... Oh, man, yeah, these got reset. I think I have to cycle it, so yeah, there you go. Now it shows resources, and that one now it shows valuables. I don't know what... I don't have a, how expensive are these again? I forget. I think we actually, from those... The salvage over here, I think we actually have enough stuff to make another vault. So I guess I'll put, let's see, there it is right there. And I don't want to make 50, I want to make 1. Yeah, I don't know why that keeps the number up there, it's kind of crazy. But we're missing 5 cemented paste, which is kind of crazy, awesome. But, yeah, I guess we'll get a mortar and pestle, because I don't think we have one over here. And yes, it looks like we actually... Oh, wait, we have an AA mortar and pestle we can make. What? Let's see. That right there. 15 hide and 65 stone. Grind resources into new items with the OCD plugin. Okay, well, if everything over here is already being made into automated ARK, I definitely do want to make, you know, as much stuff automated ARK, and then maybe delve a little bit more into the mod and start learning it more, you guys, because this is a fresh new base. We could actually... Let's make that control panel or whatever it's called, too. We have that unlocked, or I think that, doesn't it automatically unlock, or control, oh, is that it? Oh yeah, it is. Okay, 5 raw metal, so that's nothing. Then a remote control armor ocular implant, what? Enable or deactivate ocular implant on equipped armor. I don't know what that's supposed to mean. That's the little ancient alien symbol that's in our heckin' arm right there. I don't know what that is, I need to look into that. But for that, we need to make, oh, I guess you make that over here at the AA workbench as well. Let's see. Automated ARK. Why does it have an automated ARK folder? This is like the only thing for the mod. 2 raw metal right there. So I guess, I don't know. I guess I'll have to go find some raw metal somewhere. But yeah, let me update out my inventory real quick of some of the actual resources we could drop off. And I'll rebuild my folders too. So, oh, here's some metal right here. Yeah, let's grab some of the metal. We do need the raw variant of that to actually make the AA console thing. So that's good. Anyways, let's head back to the base now. And it sounds like there's a... Yep, there's an avalanche over there. Can I zoom into that? I don't think I can for some reason. Anyways, yeah, let's head back to the base. Oh, there's Bigfoot right there! Whoa! There's Bigfoot! I got a comment a little while ago saying, hey, you know, there's Bigfoot walking in the background like 2 minutes in or something like that. But there he is, there's Bigfoot! Oh man, he's like hiding in the bushes and stuff, he's pooping in the woods! He actually is, I think! I think he actually was pooping in the heckin' woods right there. We could barely see him in the shrubbery here, you guys. Whoa, this like terrible footage, it looks terrible. But it is Bigfoot, trust me. I know, I am a Bigfootologist. I think those are actual people, by the way. I'm not even joking. Anyways, let's head back to the base and let's make these new things. Oh, I think, yeah, is that another one of those oil rocks that spawn? Yeah, there's like multiple oil rocks around here, which is kind of crazy, so. Yeah, let's grab these. Who knows what we could use those for? Of course, you could actually combine them together with like hide and get gasoline out of those, which is great, but I don't know what else you could use the oil for in terms of like stuff that we'd actually use immediately, you know? So I probably end up just storing that away, because I already have a good amount of gasoline, like 70 or something like that, so. Where is that at? Ammo? Yeah, we have like 79 right now, so that's not too bad. But yeah, we got some raw metal right there, some oil, some stone, and started to organize some stuff over here a little bit, so that's not too bad. I definitely do want to make like a fridge. Didn't I say I wanted to make a fridge? Yeah, we have the AA refrigerator right there, not too bad. Yeah, we're just missing crystal, so let's actually adventure around. Because we've seen crystal somewhere. I forget where it was. It was at the top of a mountain, but I don't know exactly where that was. Kind of want to go adventure around a little bit, see if we can actually find that again. Oh yeah, let's go, do we have enough stuff? Let's see. The vault, how much was that again? Cement paste, that's what we were missing, yeah. Oh yeah, for that, we were wanting to make the console. Just so we could start out with the AA stuff. And then there's the mortar and pestle right there. Is that like an actual, it's like a chemistry bench or something crazy. Like, it doesn't look like a mortar and pestle. Like, look, it's big. Yeah, look at that, that's huge. What? Where could I fit that in? Can't fit it in here, unfortunately. I guess I'll fit it out here. Yeah, I guess I'll just put a bunch of workbenches and other stuff out here, huh? So that's good. Boom. Golly, that thing looks crazy. It's a chemistry, it actually is a chemistry station. Is it like in the wall? Is it like deep? No, it's not, actually. That looks cool, you guys. Hold on, let's get rid of that. Hold on, let's get rid of the... How do I get rid of this UI? I don't like this stuff being on the screen. I kind of want to get a good closer look at this, but look at that. There's a mortar and pestle there, mortar and pestle there, mortar and pestle there. There's like a little bowl there of narcotics, which is cool. Spark powder, there's spark powder in that mortar and pestle, spark powder there, and what looks like gunpowder or sulfur in that one light there to the left. I think those are there stim berries there to the left? Or in those bags? I don't know, and of course spoiled meat there, and of course narcotics, and it looks like salt there to kind of preserve stuff maybe, or maybe even to make preserving salt. Interesting, I like this. I like these custom made things over here, you guys. Very, very, and there's like gunpowder and other stuff there at the bottom. Yeah, look at that. Not only is there sulfur there, but there's like gunpowder and other stuff. I'm trying to make sure the labels don't show up. Yeah, look at that. And oh, that's probably cement paste. Probably one of them's gunpowder and one of them's cement paste, I bet. I bet cement paste is the one that's like right there on the left. Anyways, let's use this thing. How's this thing work? Is this like actually really good? Can I make like 15 cement base? And how good? Oh, I can make a cement base. Jeez, you need a lot of stone for this though. But how many crafts is it going to make though? It's one. Okay, 6 crafts. Not bad. How expensive was that again? The mortar and pestle. Yeah, that's cheap. That's 65 stone and actually hold on. Yeah, that is oh wait, no, that's the same price as just one mortar and pestle. Ooh. I guess if anything, it'll allow me to make these a lot faster, but it's the same price as just one mortar and pestle when supposedly we're getting like 3 of them. And of course it is automated as well. If anything, maybe they could balance that to make it like 3 times more expensive, I guess you'd say. And then of course we have the AA console, which I don't know, I guess we could put it like right here. And then of course we could interact with this thing a little bit later, and there's a little plug right there for the guy, I guess, who made the mod. But I do need to do more research into AA, because I think the mod has a lot of potential and actually has a lot of stuff that we could do, but I just don't really know too much about it, you know? I've just been using these structures and stuff because they're very, very useful, but for right now, I was trying to make the vault. I forget what we were doing. Oh yeah, some cement base. Yeah, we have enough cement base because we just made 6 right there. We only need 5. Let's make another vault, which would be, and then there's a fridge there, which we need the crystals for, which we're going to go out here in just a moment to find. So it would be, there it is right there, the marble vault. So there you go. The other ones, yeah, the OCD drop vault. OCD metal vault, 300 hacking metal, golly, that's crazy. I'll just use the OCD marble. I guess we'll make this like 3 tall. Yeah, we can make it 3 tall, no problemo, you guys. Now, if I did that, how hard is that to reach up there? I think that's the one, because I think we actually have something. Yeah, we do. I'm going to pick it up. So, pick up that. Hopefully we're selecting the right one. Hey, we were, nice. I'm going to have to reorganize these, because I don't know if... I kind of want to keep resources stuff. Like, oh, whoa. There's like 2 places I could put right there, but... Yeah, maybe I'll put like resources in this chest, which isn't going to be hard. I'll just, boop, there you go. And, move them over here. So, everything from... There you go. Nice. But yeah, I usually like having like resources and stuff like in the middle, just because, you know, that's just going to take up a lot more space, you know, resource, like multiple chests specifically for resources. So anyways, that's going to be using its custom name, which I didn't give yet, so I guess I'll do. Man, there's a lot of stuff. There you go. Rename. Let's name this one resources. There you go. And is that default name? I have to reset it. There you go. Resources. Let's rename this one. So that's let's do, I guess I'll just call it like loot or something like that. You know, because like, I don't know how we could actually classify stuff like guns, armor, weapons, saddles, all that kind of stuff, you know? So I just put all that up in there. Oh, I do need to have another one, actually. You know what? I'm going to have a folder here for random loot, I guess I could call it. And I guess I have a random folder here as well called armor and weapons. Even though it is kind of like, they do have some overlap right there. The armor weapons one, I kind of want to keep for the old gear that we wore over here. So there we go. We have that now. So that's good. Then we have some random riot armor we can put up too in the random loot. So let's do that here. There you go. And let's cycle this one so it uses the name. There you go. Loot. I guess we'll just call it loot for right now. Of course, we're going to organize it a little bit more when we have like 4 or 5 volts or something like that. But when there's only 3, I guess we'll do with what we have right now, huh? We do have some random leftover structures here. I guess I'll try and get rid of them. Just kind of get some of the resources back, you know? So there you go. Oh, whoops. Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. I like how it automatically, like, reselects these, which is nice. So, demolish it. Oh, wait. Structure variants. Yeah, we switch it to thatch, wood, adobe, and I'll just switch it back to demolished. Not even existing anymore, Hater. Yeah, let's get some of the resources back from these, just because I made extra structures over here. So I guess I'll place them down and just kind of get some of the resources back and, of course, put it up inside of storage. But once we get rid of all these here in just a moment, I definitely do want to go out and try and find some Echo Crystal, because I know we found them a little while ago. I don't know exactly when, but I know they're, like, towards the top of a mountain or something like that, and then once we make that, we can actually make the fridge, which is going to be great, you guys. So, let's place down another, the other smithy, the regular smithy, not the S-plus one. An electrical generator, which we don't need because we have the wireless variant of that, which I guess doesn't really make too much sense because we could just add a heckin' junction box on top of this thing and it's going to be quote-unquote wireless anyways. And wires aren't really too expensive, they're just like 5 metal or something like that for one. So I don't know why I really made the wireless one, but at least it's kind of cool, huh? So, there he goes, just demolish these and get some of the structures, or some of the stone, some of the wood, some of the thatch back, and of course put it back inside of our resources chest. And that should cover everything. Yeah, look at that, we got a little bit of, what do we get the electronics and metal from right there? Oh yeah, from the generator, probably, I bet, huh? So that's kind of cool, so we actually got some of the electronics back, that's great. Because I do remember spending some, like buying electronics and actually using it to make that, so that's great. I guess for right now, I'll put up the, random loot, I'll put up the... There you go, the blueprint and that thing right up there. So that's good. And let's actually head out here in just a second, guys. Oh, wait, yeah, we have this in our hotbar, too. So let's maybe get rid of those. And let's put them up over here. Nice. All right, let's go out here, you guys. Let's see. Where do we go? Oh, I bet that... Oh, are there crystals at the top of that thing right there? Because I know it's going to be at the top of, like, a cliff or a mountain or a hill or something like that. I doubt this is going to give us any crystal. Mammoth right there, though. Maybe I'll get my, my guy to turn into big beast mode. To heck in werewolf mode, and we'll just kind of roam around with him, huh? Let's get our element back. I just put it up in the there you go. Let's put it right there. Actually, I think we might still be able to do it if it's not on like the last item slot right there. So let's go to, oh, he has another level up. Nice. 10% addiction. It actually went down, so I guess he's going to be a little bit weaker, huh? So that's going to suck. But either way, let's do. He actually has 2 level ups: health and melee damage. Nice. And let's go to 7. Oh, that works too. All right, so it don't have to be in the lotto, the last item slot right there. So that's great. So now he's going to evolve into big boy mode, the beast, the werewolf, and there you go. All right, nice. Now, let's see. Yeah, he's got pretty good health. 3,000 melee damage, 278. Golly, I wish 2,700. Sheesh. 221 damage to this mammoth though, so that's pretty good. Let's get our spyglass out. We already killed the mammoth right there. Golly, he's only like what was that? Level 6? Not really the highest level or anything like that, but. Let's just go around now and try and find ourselves some heckin' crystals, you guys. I do know up here we do have some, I think, obsidian and maybe a couple more metal. I doubt we're going to find, oh god, another heckin' avalanche? Man! Yeah, there's some metal right there, which is good. Can I jump over this thing with this guy? I think I did right there. Or at least go around it. So that's good. But yeah, metal right there. Should I get it? I guess we'll grab it real quick, just because we are going to be, you know, collecting resources, so might as well grab this stuff. 87 metal, that's good. 188. Oh, I think we have some raw metal at home. Probably should have set that to start a smelt. Oh, is that obsidian? It is. Yep. See, it's hard to see these because they're covered in snow, which makes sense because, you know, we're in a snow biome. But yeah, it's hard to see the obsidian. I'm like, at least obsidian's like black. You can actually really sticks out like a sore thumb. But when it's covered in snow, really, really hides it here, you guys. But there you go. 143 obsidian. A lot of obsidian here. 179 and 225. I think I'm going to stop right there just so we don't get too much and like over encumber ourselves. All right, you guys are back. I think I actually found exactly where we saw the crystal like 5-6 episodes ago or so by now. Look at this big thing right here. This looks familiar, huh? This weird structure. And then we came over here, landed like with our glide suit or something. I think we just made the glide suit pretty recently at the time. But yeah, over here we've got a lot of crystal. I feel like we harvested some crystal here, huh? I guess we didn't, because I guess I just... Oh, either that or we have the crystal back home and... Probably should have grabbed it whenever I was back home, whenever I... Alright, I guess we can... Oh, I forgot to make a bed! Let's go home, let's make a bed. Just in case, you guys, but... I don't know, maybe while we're out and about... Hey, you know what, we can teleport with Helena. We'll just go home real quick, make the bed, just to be safe. And, of course, we'll be a little bit closer to the Ferox cave, so that'd be great. Let's continue grabbing some... Actually, let's grab all the crystal over here, just because why not? Let's actually start grabbing all of them, that way we don't have to worry about coming back here, wherever in the world this is. Well, at least I have my coordinates at the top. So we can actually see exactly where this is. And hey, if you guys are playing too, and you guys want to figure out, hey, how do I, where can I find crystal? Well, 84, whatever, and 36, whatever. That seems to be about it, because that's exactly where I am right now, so that's good. Either way, that's all the crystal I saw. Oh, wait. I don't think there's crystal over there. I think those are the, or maybe there is? Oh, yeah, there is. I guess I'll go grab some real quick. Oh, and there's, oh, wait. Yeah, those cactus plants. Yeah, you know what? Maybe we'll grab those just in case we actually need them. And of course, we're about to make a fridge anyway, so we can actually store them inside the fridge and make them last longer, not spoil, so that's good. Let's grab all the crystal over here as well. I don't know how much, but surely we're getting closer and closer to the carry weight limit, I bet. Oh, and then there's those, yeah, these weird cactus things. What do I guess I'll get them with a hatchet, huh? There you go. 75 cactus sap. 92,000. I guess I'll get him with a pickaxe, actually. Yeah, we saw him. Oh, yep, there's another one right there. Just because I think the pickaxe has better melee damage, and of course, we're getting thatch, so. Never mind. We got way less cactus sap right there, but way more thatch. Hey, even some metal. I grabbed that. Well, there's a third. Yep, there's another one right there. You know what? Let's get this one with a sword, just because why not? And it was about in the middle right there. 62 cactus sap, 62 thatch. So I don't know which thing is better. I guess it depends on what you want, more cactus sap or more thatch, huh? But anyways, that's all the crystal I see right here, at least right now. There may be more on the mountains. I'll look around, and of course the crystal is like white, so you can't really even see it too well against all the snow. Just like talked about a moment ago with the obsidian being snow-capped and stuff like that. But yeah, let's go back to our Baby Yoda. Time remaining is kind of going out right now, but you know what? That's not that big of a deal. We're about to tame another Ferox anyways, so let's go over to Helena. Oh, say hello. Let's head back home to Arctic North.
Right on target.
All right, we're back. There's Dinosaur right there. Let's kill him. Try and get some more, because we're about to level up. We just need a little bit more XP, and we're good, you guys. Whoa, I just sent that Therizinosaur. We sent small creatures in the air before. Didn't know we were able to send heckin' Therizinosaurs. They're like the same size as us, basically. They're very similar, actually. We both have the claw meme going on. We're just kind of swiping at each other, but I've got double the claws. You've got four heckin' arms, Ada. Now we have to go, which... Oh, whoa, whoops. I accidentally just jumped right there. Ooh, don't want to be on a cliffside while this guy's about to potentially transform back into cute mode. Because who knows, I might fall to the heckin' cliff and die. So, anyways, yes, let's just start doing these weird sprint jump memes. And kind of combo them together so we can actually jump even further. But we're already back at the base, so don't need to worry about that. But there you go. Wait for him to expire. I don't think we'd actually force him to go back into cute mode just yet. But there was a level up right there, which is good. So let's actually give him another, let's give him another health right there. I probably should have done, like, stamina. He was getting kind of low on stamina here and there, but not that big of a deal. Do we have the bed already unlocked? We do not. Well, we obviously did earlier on. Oh, whoa. I suppose bunk bed. I don't know why there's like so many repeats right here, you guys, but I guess we'll get the bunk bed. It does require a lot of polymer, though. 80. Man. 200 pelt. 300 wood? I guess I get the simple bed, you know, just so we actually have it. bunk bed, I guess we'll unlock those, just kind of have the thing unlocked because we have 3,000 engrams anyways. So, bed. Just make that in my inventory. I guess I get the S-plus variant of that. I wonder if we could do anything special with it, you know? Kind of like you kind of make the foundations out of like wood or whatever for S plus. I wonder if you could do anything special for the bed. I could lay in the bed and just kind of, you know, just lay there. But I don't want to do that. I guess I'll rename this one Arctic Base. There you go, Arctic Base. I don't know what to actually name it though. You know what? It's been a little while since I've asked you guys for a name for something. Ever since we named Baby Yoda, I don't know, 4 or 5 episodes ago. So yeah, leave comments down below. What should we name our new Arctic base over here? Which I really do like, and it's like under this big structure, so I guess if you guys want to take this into account, maybe you can come up with some sort of weird name incorporating this giant structure that's going on out here. And yeah, just leave a comment down below with a name suggestion. If you guys see a really cool name suggestion down there in the comments, be sure to give it a thumbs up. That way I know a lot of you guys like it. Oh, yep, he's back into cute modes. That's good. But yeah, I don't know, maybe like an episode or two, I'll check the comments, see whatever one has the most likes. And I guess we'll name our bed that name. That way, you know, whenever we die again, we'll actually know, okay, let's spawn back at whatever the name of this base is, you know. But yeah, leave name suggestions down in the comments down below. What do you guys want to name this new Arctic base? And we'll probably end up naming it here in about an episode or two. And like I said, be sure to like any comments down there that you guys think are really good names. That way I know which ones you guys like the most. And I'll be more likely to pick them, too.